I'm sure by now all of us, or most of us, have seen stories around VBS, and yeah, it has been topical in the news, newspapers, TVs, podcasts, and commentators speaking about the matter of VBS, VBS. But why am I talking about VBS? I'm talking about VBS because one of the accused in the case for VBS by the name of Kabelo Matsepe, he's also finding himself again on the other side of law, where he's actually battling the court cases with SARS. Yes, as a result of his services or his involvement in VBS. Yes, that's where it gets interesting for tax purposes. So what happened is that last year, SARS took him to a high court to actually render or obtain rather a sequestration order against his estate, claiming that his estate is actually factually insolvent, meaning that his total liabilities actually are more than assets as presented to the High Court. And then the result was that the court found in favor of SARS, the South African Revenue Service. So that is pretty much it. But the facts that caught my attention, which was quite interesting, that I felt that most of you guys need to learn. So the facts that were presented was that this gentleman actually provided what you call marketing and capital raising services to VBS, and he actually alleged, well, based on the facts that are on the court judgment, he obviously rendered those services through the company. However, the assessment was raised, individual income tax assessments was raised against him personally, and also the VAT assessment. Of course, there are legal grounds on why SARS took that option, and that was not contested, but the issue of the court case was him fighting against his estate being sequestrated. So that's very important. So one of the mistakes that he did, and which I know that most people do, is that when they get an assessment from SARS, is they don't respond. They don't attend to those assessments as early as possible, because there are rules that you need to object to the assessment if you're not happy with the assessment within specific timelines, and failure to that can render that assessment final, and therefore you cannot do anything unless certain provisions actually are applicable, which can be very onerous to prove otherwise, right? So in his case, the facts are that he did not actually object to those assessments. Therefore, the issue of validity or the issue of those assessments was taken as final because he did not actually object timeously or at all. That's what the court judgment is actually stipulating. So therefore, the judge found that the assessment that was issued by SARS was considered to be final. So the interesting part is that the assets were listed there, and the debt that SARS was trying to recover from him was over 60 million rand. That's quite heavy. So one of the arguments that also he put forward was that marketing and capital raising were offer financial services in nature, therefore should not be included as part of that, meaning that should not be part of a VAT taxable surplus, meaning that he doesn't want to pay VAT on those particular fees. But they found that no, actually, marketing and capital raising services were not listed as what you call financial services in terms of Section 2 of Value Added Tax Act. And which is true, if you read Section 2 of the Value Added Tax Act, you'll find that capital raising and marketing services are not included as one that is considered financial services. Okay, so meaning that those grants could not hold water, therefore the VAT assessment is actually that was raised as a result of those services is still valid, right? So that is one of the things that he raised there. Of course, also he tried to argue that there's no relation between him and the company. There must be a separation between him and the company because he did not personally render those services. And the judge actually reprimanded, and he was quite assertive to say, listen, you can't argue that if you knew how the company laws work, you cannot try to distance yourself as a director of a company. But it's very, very important to me because it brings me to your attention to say, be mindful that you could actually be held liable for your company's tax debts. So that is very, very important for you as an entrepreneur or owner, business owner, to understand that you could find yourself, if you don't do things thoroughly, honestly, diligently, and you don't become negligent, you could find yourself being liable for, in this case, even him, liable for income tax and VAT, or for that matter, any tax that was supposed to go into the company. You find yourself being personally liable, which reminds me another court case of Christopher's that is similar to, it's a similar in a principle that SARS is going after the directors of a particular case. But I'll do a video separately on this matter. So I just wanted to give you these facts around this gentleman. But at the end of the day, obviously, the courts found that they actually granted the sequestration order in favor of SARS. So I think for me, the lessons that I feel that it's key here is what happens, and I think that's what you need to know. I don't think you are interested in the story and the facts behind the case, but what are the lessons that we should learn from there? First of all, don't do the wrong things, right? Let's get that out of the way. But equally so, let's say for argument's sake, you get assessments, VAT, income tax, pay as you earn, and then you're not happy with whatever that assessment that you are getting. So meaning that you've got a right as a taxpayer to actually object to that. And if your objection is actually denied, you can actually appeal against such decision. So there are guidelines within the Tax Administration Act that you can actually follow. So don't make a mistake of not responding to the objections. Don't make mistakes of not responding to the assessment unless you agree with what SARS is saying within those assessments. And I think that to me, that is very, very, very important. It's important to note that should you actually not even object and it gets to the point where that particular and it's out of those guidelines or the rules within the Tax Administration Act, that assessment will be considered to be final in terms of Section 100 of Tax Administration Act. And that's why it's so important. Any correspondence that you get from South African Revenue Services that you can't interpret or you don't even understand it, please reach out to people who understand these tax matters so that you are able to find yourself, meaning that you are not going to compromise yourself, and for that matter, you still be able to exercise and take advantage of the rights that you are granted in terms of Tax Administration Act. And then you could sometimes get successfully found that maybe there were issues that actually by providing supporting documents, then SARS is able to reverse some of the amounts, and then you pay a reasonable tax legally. So those are my lessons from this court case. I hope you learned something. All the best, and read any correspondence from SARS. Good luck.